This video is for electronics assemblers who currently or are considering using nitrogen during their processes. It includes details regarding when nitrogen should be used.
Dr. Lasky, you and I know that one of the ongoing issues in soldering and surface mount and through-hole has been the use of nitrogen. First of all, is it really needed? Does it add anything to the process? And at the same time, the economics of it, it is an additional cost to the process. And I seem to recall there was an episode in The Adventures of Patty and the Professor where they encountered this issue.
Yeah. You know, Phil, this is one of the more comical stories in Patty and the Professor, and absolutely based on a true situation. So Patty arrives at the facility, and she's walking past a reflow oven, and she notices what looked like stalactites hanging from the ceiling. And what had happened is the flux had condensed from the reflow oven, and dust had collected on that, and it was never cleaned. So she asked her host about this, and he said that management had done a financial analysis and had determined that cleaning did not pay financially. And so they did not clean the facility at all, which was obvious. There was dust on the floor and paper and everything. Right. But they didn't even clean the restrooms. And they counted on the workers to do that. So it was one of the more comical Patty and the Professor episodes.
Talk about a lack of industrial hygiene,
right,
if you will.
Right.
But what about the nitrogen?
Oh, gee,
this issue.
Yeah. Well, you know, one of the things, Phil, in reflow, customers should be able to demand of their solder paste suppliers that nitrogen not be needed.
Mm-hmm. Totally.
So if your solder paste supplier said, well, you probably should use nitrogen, you probably should be going to a different solder paste supplier, because modern solder paste shouldn't need nitrogen in the reflow process. But wave soldering is a different animal.
Yes, it is.
And I found in most cases, nitrogen really helps. Now, there may be some cases where it's not needed, but nitrogen really helps. Well, in this situation, what happened is management had just decided that they didn't want to pay for nitrogen anymore, so they turned the nitrogen off in the wave solder process, and I'll bet you can guess what happened.
Yes.
The first pass yield went from 95% to 80%. And, you know, the lesson here is that you should never make a move like this without doing some sort of designed experiment or something to show that you could get successful yield without using nitrogen.
Where can we find the complete story of this?
Well, this story, the full story, is chronicled in Patty and the Professor on page 33. If you don't have a copy of Patty and the Professor, you can download it on Indian.com.
Very good. Dr. Lasky, thank you.